You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download.
So while we're still on this left side of the head, I can go and show you how I did some of the arcs. So here again, we have our upper left shape here, and I'm going to add some arcs on this edge just so it's not perfectly smooth. It's sort of broken up. But what I'm going to do for this, I'm going to actually copy this layer here. I'm going to duplicate it, and then I'm going to move it out of the hair core demo up to the top. So I'm going to lock this, and then I don't need this shape anymore. I'm going to just delete it. First, I have to unlock the layer, and now I can add in some arcs. Hit B, start making my shapes. And then I'm going to check to see if they move along with my tracked shape. And if they didn't move close enough, then I would have to make another tracked layer from points on that edge. But I think this looks pretty good. I'm just trying to reduce the amount of work I have to do. But I think actually we're going to be okay with the motion blur. And if I want to duplicate and have even more shapes, what I can do here is I can select all of these. I can have more shapes by just using the multiframe tool and duplicating my existing shapes. So I can select my existing shapes, Command D, and now I have copies of them. And then I can select the multiframe tool, like I said, and the border becomes red. And then I can move my shapes up or out from the original placement. So now I have double the shapes and they're all in different places. And then if I want to see them in the alpha and I click A in the overlay, you actually can't see open shapes unless they have a stroke width applied to them. So let's do that. I'll apply a stroke width of 1. So now when I cycle through the alpha overlays, you can now see the shapes. And next up, we're going to make some closed shapes. So I'm going to just collapse these existing layers now. We'll zoom out and we'll take a look at this screen left lower section here. I'm going to use this shape here, the tracking data from this shape, and let's find which one that is. Okay, that is a screen left lower head core, and I'm just going to try to do a straight duplicate, because if you see the tracking matrix data here, I just needed 3 keyframes. That means that my tracking was pretty good. And I'll just turn on my tracking shape to show you. Play it through. And that captured the movement pretty well. So we'll just turn this off again, and I'll duplicate this, Command D, and I'll move this out of the head core demo layer. We'll move that right up to the top. I'm going to delete the core shape because I don't need it, but I'm also going to just lock this head core layer. Okay, so now I can drop shapes in here. I probably don't even need the tracking shape anymore, but I'll just leave it. And I'm going to look for strands of hair that are pretty much opaque. So we'll go with this piece of hair here. So I'll just start making my shape. And carry it down into the torso. And sometimes when I make my closed shapes for hair, I like to have the points directly opposite on the shape itself. So you can see here, points are next to each other on opposite sides of the shape. It's just another way to kind of help me keep track of the points, that I'm not moving things around too much. Okay, then we can just play this through and see what adjustments I need to make. Some rotation here, T, set the pivot with W. Maybe I'll just select these points and rotate this section, T, W, and rotate this out. And then finally, just a little bit of point editing. Alt Z to go in between. Looks pretty good. And then just scrub through. Okay, there's going to be some more editing here because the hair goes in and out. So we'll just go to this middle frame here, make a keyframe. I just want to make a little edit, put those in, and anchor this shape in this place. Go in between. Alt X to go in between these two keyframes. That looks pretty good. And just a little scrub through again. Just something here. So we'll just move the shape in here as a whole. It's going to need more keyframing down the line, and we can just do that as well. That's the nature of hair. It just moves at its own will. But the tracking is taking some of the work out of the equation. At least the hair is pretty much anchored to the side of the head, or the side of the hair, which helps. So we just have to deal with this movement in here. So I won't finish the shape because that'll take a long time. But if we go back to our Roto Final and we try to turn off some of these layers so we can see what we're doing here. And we'll turn off the arcs. So now you can see my closed shapes. So the tracking really takes a lot of the work out of the equation.